Students, today we are going to discuss about interference due to wedge-shaped film. So here if we are considering two glass plates, OS and OT, and let us assume human hair or thin paper or thin thread is introduced in between these two glass plates, then one side of these two glass plates will incline at certain angle. So that angle we are getting here is called as wedge angle, and the film we are getting here due to these two glass plates and human hair which is introduced here is called as wedge shaped film. As shape of the film is wedge shape, so it is called as wedge shaped film. So this angle normally alpha, wedge angle, is very very small, as only a small hair or thread is introduced in between these two glass plates. Now this point O is called as edge of wedge or point of contact, where thickness of the film we are getting is zero, and thickness of the film goes on increasing as we go away from this point of contact or from point O. So thickness is not uniform in this wedge shape film, it is varying continuously. It is zero at point of contact and it goes on increasing as we go away from edge of wedge or point of contact. So when monochromatic light will be incident from upper side on this wedge shaped film, then reflected light as well as transmitted light corresponds or gives you interference pattern. So interference pattern can be seen in reflected light as well as in transmitted side, but as in reflected side, the reflected rays are approximately having same intensity or same amplitude as compared to its transmitted side. So in reflected case, sharp and clear interference pattern can be produced. So we will discuss only about reflected case in this interference due to wedge shape film, and for this article first we will try to find out path difference and then conditions to produce bright and dark bands. So let us consider a ray which is emitted by monochromatic light is incident here on this wedge shaped film. So let us say this ray is AB. So monochromatic ray AB here is incident on this wedge shaped film. So when ray reaches at point B, part of it get reflect back into same media as the film is transparent, and part of it get transmitted or refracted into next media. So 4% of coming intensity get reflected back into next media. So this BX is reflected ray due to the film, and 96% of coming intensity get refracted into the film. So let us see, BC is the refracted ray due to the film. Now again, when the ray reaches at point C, part of it get reflect back into same media, means 4% of coming intensity get reflected back and 96% get transmitted. Our aim is to study reflected case only. So I will show reflected ray here. So this CD is the reflected ray due to the film, and again from point D the ray will refract into next media. So let us say this DY is the refracted ray. So here when monochromatic ray AB is incident on the film, this BX and DY are the reflected rays due to the wedge shape film. So interference of these two causes alternate bright and dark bands. So dark bands we can see in this wedge shape film at different thickness, and with the help of spectrometer from upper side the fringes can be seen. So we need to find whether we are getting bright or dark. So whether we are getting bright or dark band or bright or dark fringe, that can be decided by path difference between this BX and DY. So let us try to find out path difference. So path difference for BX and DY is BC plus CD, as B is emerging from BX is emerging from point B, but DY has covered extra path from B to C and C to D. So BC plus CD is the extra path traveled by DY with respect to BX. And to know the exact part difference, I will draw a perpendicular from point D to BX. Let us say this point is M. And I will make one more construction here. I will draw a perpendicular from point D to BC. Let us assume this point is N. So now, path difference, let us say, it is denoted by delta. So delta path difference equals to BC plus CD, extra part traveled by DY with respect to BX, and BM, extra part traveled by BX with respect to DY. So BC plus CD minus BM, and this BC plus CD path is in the film, let us say, of refractive index mu, and this upper medium is air medium whose refractive index is approximately considered as 1. So this delta can be written as mu in bracket BC plus CD minus BM. So we need to find out this BC plus CD minus BM. Now here, this angle is angle of incidence I. This angle is angle of refraction R. So I will consider two right angle triangles in this diagram, that is BMD and BND, and I will apply Snell's law those two triangles. So by applying Snell's law, two triangle BMD and right angle triangle BND. Sin I by sin R equals to refractive index mu. So sin I in right angle triangle BMD is opposite side, that is BM divided by hypotenuse BD. So BM divided by BD, and sin R in BND is opposite side, that is BN divided by hypotenuse is BD. So BN by BD, this equals to mu. So BD is common, so it get cancels, and BM can be written as mu into BN. So put the value of BM in this part difference relation. So by putting BM in path difference relation, path difference delta can be written as mu is common now in all the terms. So mu in bracket BC plus CD minus BN. So now we need to find out BC plus CD minus BN. Now here I will make some constructions in the diagram. I will draw a perpendicular from point B, but that perpendicular is to glass plate OS. So I will draw a normal or perpendicular . Then I will draw one more perpendicular which passes through point D and a perpendicular which passes through point C and perpendicular to the lower glass plate. Now here, I will increase length of this BC in forward direction so that it intersect to this normal which is passing through point D. So I will increase length of BC in forward direction. And now you can see, let us say this point is E. We are getting an isosceles triangle DCE where this CD is equals to CE and these two angles are equal. These two angles are equal. So first let us try to find out this angle and then we will discuss about the part difference relation. So here, okay, sorry. This angle, angle between normal and angle of refracted ray is called as angle of refraction R. So 90 minus R means this we got R. Now let us say this point is F. So I will write here in short. In this right angle triangle OCF, angle F is equals to, as this angle O is alpha, angle C is 90 degrees. So remaining angle, angle F here will be 90 minus alpha. This angle in angle, sorry, in right, in triangle BCF, angle B equals to, this angle is R, so this will be 90 minus R. So 90 minus R. Now in the same triangle BCF, this we got as 90 minus R. This angle F we got as 90 minus alpha. So the third remaining angle, that is angle C, is equals to total sum of all these angles must be 180 degree. So angle C will be R plus alpha. So this angle, angle C, will be R plus alpha. Now here in this diagram, these two are the perpendiculars I have drawn to lower glass plate OS. Means these two are parallel lines. This BE is intersecting to these two parallel lines. So this angle we got as R plus alpha. Means this angle is also same. That is R plus alpha. So this angle we got R plus alpha. Now all the required information is with us. So let us try to find out this part difference. Now in this part difference we are having BC plus CD minus BN. And here this CD is equals to CE, as this CDE is an isosceles triangle. So instead of CD I will substitute CE. So delta part difference can be written as mu in bracket BC plus C minus BN. Now this BE is a straight line because I have increased length of this BC in forward direction so that it is intersecting to this normal. So BC plus CE minus this BN is equals to EN. So for this full calculation we can write EN. So delta part difference now can be written as mu into EN. So now we are having only one unknown term and that can be calculated because this EN is associated with an right angle triangle END where this is R plus alpha. So this side, that is EN, is adjacent side of this right angle triangle and adjacent can be calculated by taking cosine angle. So I will consider right angle triangle END and in that cos of R plus alpha cosine angle will be adjacent side, that is EN, divided by hypotenuse, that is DE. So EN can be written as DE cos of R plus alpha. And D here, as here this is wedge shape film, so everywhere for every fringe thickness will be different. So I will consider at this place thickness of the film is TN. So if thickness of the film is TN, then this full DE will be twice of TN. So this EN can be written as 2 Tn cos of r plus alpha. So substitute the value of E and here in this relation. So delta can be written as 2 mu Tn cos of r plus alpha. So here all the term in this part difference are known to us. Mu is refractive index of the film, Tn is thickness of nth film, r is refraction angle and alpha is wedge angle. But as the interference we are getting due to reflected rays from denser medium, so when this ray bx will reflect from this film, which is a denser medium, it causes extra path of lambda by 2, and here there is no extra path for this reflected ray, so they are lagging by lambda by 2. So effective path difference delta here is equals to 2 mu t cos of r plus alpha plus minus lambda by 2. So here this path difference is depending upon refractive index of the film, thickness of the film, angle of refraction, wedge angle and incident wavelength. And now apply conditions. So bright band or bright fringe we are getting if this path difference is integral multiple of lambda. So if 2 mu t cos of r plus alpha plus minus lambda by 2, if this equals to n lambda, then that gives you bright band or bright fringe. Now just by taking this lambda by 2 in right hand side, and if we are solving this, then we will get 2 mu t cos of r plus alpha equals to 2n plus minus 1 lambda by 2. So this is the condition for constructive interference or bright fringe in case of wedge shape film. Now condition for dark, I will write for destructive interference. If this path difference 2 mu t cos of r plus alpha plus minus lambda by 2, if that equals to odd half multiple of lambda, that is 2n plus minus 1 lambda by 2, then this gives you dark band or destructive interference. So here also by taking this lambda by 2 in right hand side, and if we are solving this, then we will get n plus 1 lambda, where n is an integer that takes values from 1 to infinity. So n or n plus 1 can be written as n only. So 2 mu t cos of r plus alpha equals to n lambda. So this is the condition for destructive interference or dark band. So in this way we are getting conditions for bright and dark or constructive and destructive interference. So n takes values from 1, 2, 3 and so on. So remember, in this wedge shaped film, at t equals to 0 or at this point of contact or edge of wedge, the fringe we are getting is always a dark fringe. And the reason is, here this part will not come into the path difference relation. As thickness is 0, so there is no effective path taken by incident and reflected rays. So actual path difference for the rays which are reflecting from point O or the point at which t equals to 0 is lambda by 2 only, and lambda by 2 is the condition for dark band or destructive interference. So at t equals to 0 or at edge of wedge, we are getting always a dark fringe or dark band. Now this experiment, interference due to wedge shape film, can be studied to measure thickness of human hair or thickness of thin paper, or this can be used to check flatness of the surfaces. So these are applications we are getting with the help of interference due to wedge shaped film. Thank you. Thank you very much.